Instead of politicians doling out money behind a veil of secrecy, decisions about where we invest will be made public and informed by independent experts whenever. Still, this month's job numbers are a sign that we've begun to put the brakes on this recession and that the worst may be behind us. But I'm confident that we can meet the challenges we face and leave behind something better, that we're ready to take responsibility for our future once again, as individuals and as a nation. In fact, what's remarkable is not that we've had a spirited debate about health insurance reform, but the unprecedented consensus that has come together. Our economy as a whole can't move ahead if small businesses and the middle class continue to fall behind.
This is referenced in the news report I mentioned. We've now fallen behind most wealthy countries in our high school graduation rates. Some people simply forgot that behind every dollar traded or leveraged, there is a family looking to buy a house, pay for an education, open a business, or save for retirement.
We're called to honor them by doing our part for the loved ones our fallen heroes have left behind and looking after our military families. We don't know who's behind these ads, and we don't know who's paying for them. We don't know who's behind these ads or who's paying for them.
And the idea behind this year's theme, Simple Gifts, is that the greatest blessings of all are the ones that don't cost a thing. The comfort of spending time with loved ones, the freedoms we enjoy as Americans, and the joy we feel upon giving something of ourselves.